So guys, Jesus here from Hustling Labs, and today we're diving into something super cool for all of you bubble developers out there. And we're going to show you how to send data to a pop-up from a repeating room. But first, let me tell you why this is so awesome. So imagine you're building a killer e-commerce website and you want your users to click on a product and see all the juicy details in a slick pop-up. Or as in the sample that we're going to show you today, you have a task and you want to open it and get more detail. This is what we're going to be working on, how to send the data from that repeating group to the pop-up so you can display all the data that you need in that pop-up out there for your clients. Now, the possibilities are endless, but let's stop talking and let's start building. This is a project that I have been working on, Tasker Labs, and this is going to be a new template that I will be launching relatively soon. Well, here in a few months, but I'm going to show you exactly how I'm going to manage this, even though this is not the functionality that will be in this project, but it will give you a better idea of how to execute this, sending data to a pop-up from a repeating group. So here's that repeating group we're going to be working on, and these are the projects that we have ongoing and their due dates. Now, when you click on the project, there will be a pop-up. Right now, it doesn't do anything. So let's go back to the front end, double click, and here is the action. What we want to do is, and this is just a regular repeating group, just for your awareness. We are going to drop a pop-up here, and that will be called Project Details Pop-up. And that will be a column that will have padding all around. And let's not worry about anything else. So let's drop name. And what we want to do is this is going to be project. And that's it for now. So what we're going to do is that we're going to grab this test, and this is going to be parent group project name. And that's all we're going to do as of right now. This would be, we are going to hide this pop-up. We are going to create a workflow. The first thing that we're going to do is we're going to display the data into the project details pop-up, and the data to display is the parent group project, and that's what we're going to do. And then we're going to show the pop-up up there, and let's try this out now. And as you can tell, we opened the Desmily CRM. It opened Desmily CRM. If we open Societal Labs, it opens Societal Labs. But let's do a little bit more just to show you that it really does work. For some reason, this is not working. So let's see. And it's going to be. I don't know. Okay, so this is going to be due date. The due date formatted as June 20th. And we are going to bold. Cool. Let's refresh this page and make sure that all the data is appearing correctly. As you can tell, May 30th is for Desmond CRM. Let's see, May 30th. Societal Labs is July 1st and July 1st. So all the data is appearing correctly. And there you have it. This is a way, this is the way that you can send data from a repeating group to a pop-up. If you have any questions, make sure you leave them down in the comments below. I would love to answer your questions. If you like this video, make sure you subscribe and like the videos and follow me, subscribe to the channel. It helps me reach more people and hopefully help some other developers out there improve their bubble skills. And thank you for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video.